This is Absolute Radio.
Did I hear that you were trying to get a Spice Girls cover off the ground?
I tried a Spice Girls cover and it sounded shocking. On an acoustic with a raspy voice, it just sounded crap.
It's Absolute Radio, backstage at the Isle of Wight Festival. I'm Pete Donaldson and I'm joined by Tom Walker.
Hello!
Now, you've just done a wonderful set for us.
I have indeed.
A couple of tracks on your acoustic guitar.
Aye.
You were hungover. And that's you hungover.
That's me hungover. I may have got a bit too involved with the Fatboy Slim gig last night. And I got a bit excited. It's like first time I've chilled at a festival, really.
Yeah.
And I just got a bit carried away. And I had the most fun, but I woke up this morning just like, you idiot! Playing in front of like tens of thousands of people on the main stage and then doing acoustic session afterwards. Easy peasy when you're hungover.
He was so good though, wasn't he? I guess we were talking about the graphics.
Yeah.
You got to get involved with that kind of caper. I mean, it would be a little bit out of your character musically.
It was so good. I was like blown away by the set. There's so much energy and just like tunes I hadn't heard as well. And old fan favourites, and I don't know, it's just mint. I was boogieing the whole time, man.
Fantastic stuff. Obviously, you've had a pretty full year as well. Brit Award, number one album. And you've talked to me three times, which
exactly.
is obviously the biggest
the
prize.
The highlight, of course, yes.
Have you had time to sort of take stock a little bit?
Not really. I've just been on the move. I did a bit of writing recently, and I hadn't written anything since December.
Oh, nice.
And in 6 days I did seven tunes, which was so nice because I love writing that. It's hard to do it on the road, you know what
yeah.
I mean, like on the back of the bus when everyone's being noisy and like you need your own time, your
Someone's
own space
put FIFA
to do it.
On the PlayStation.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. So that was nice, but yeah, other than that, we've just been on the move, man. Like
yeah.
I cannot believe. I thought it was Saturday today. It's not even. It's Sunday, isn't it? That's the kind of like wave we're on at the moment.
Where are you off to next? Are you off to somewhere?
I've got no idea.
Not a clue.
Not a clue. I'm just looking at my diary in the morning of the day and then just hoping for the best.
Well, speaking of Saturdays, obviously you're on Saturday Kitchen.
Oh yeah.
You've made it.
That is
the sign of someone who's made it.
The pinnacle. Yeah.
And you enjoyed the cheesy naan.
Oh mate, that cheese naan was something else, mate. It was amazing. Like I thought I was going to get peas, but the nation. They sorted me out.
Sorted
and I had
you
curry
out.
And a cheese naan at like 10 in the morning.
You'd go for one now, wouldn't you? You'd go
course,
for that now.
Any time, mate. Breakfast, lunch or dinner. I'm in for a cheese naan.
What's the best thing about an Indian? Is it the poppadoms?
Just all of it, mate. You never leave an Indian feeling not like absolutely stuffed out your face, do you? You're like, you just stuff your face at an Indian. I'm not condoning it, but it is good fun.
I'm not condoning eating Indian food.
But yeah, I'm not condoning.
I'm not condoning
overeating Indian food.
Overindulging. Obviously, festival season means a heck of a lot of porta cabins.
Yes. Yeah.
Can I get a three-word review of your backstage area, so to speak?
It's actually all right. It's in a Premier Inn this year.
Oh, so, nice. Okay.
Yeah, so it's all right. We've got two day rooms. Lovely they are.
Oh,
great.
Nice.
Yeah. Premier Inn's good. I can deal with Premier Inn. You know
what's
what I mean?
What's the best porta cabin you've experienced this festival season?
It's only second festival.
Ah, okay, right.
And the other one the other day was that was in like some kind of abandoned army building. So they had like a gym in there or in the backstage area.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Bit weird.
Pump some iron.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, get pumped up before the gig.
How is obviously? I guess your home life is you've got a fiance. Has she seen much of you lately?
Seen her about seven times since we got engaged in August. So.
Well, congratulations, yeah,
thank
man.
Thank you. But I don't know, she's good with it, man. She's like so lovely. Like when we met, I didn't actually have a job.
Yeah.
And I was nowhere in the music industry. And I was just knocking on doors trying to get stuff done. So she's been with me for the whole journey and is so supportive and lovely and just... She's the one, mate. She's
yeah.
the absolute one. She
and I guess
never
she's
gives me
a piece of quiet now.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, she probably likes it because I'm never about, you know.
Sounds to herself. So when you came into Absolute Radio a little while ago, you did a fantastic cover of an Imagine Dragons track.
Oh yeah.
The fans were just enraptured by it.
Oh,
they were really
great.
Excited by it. Did I hear that you were trying to get a Spice Girls cover off the ground?
I tried a Spice Girls cover and it sounded shocking. Like, what I realised is like they're very good at writing songs, but you kind of need a bit of that production in there for a Spice Girls track. And on an acoustic with a raspy voice, it just sounded crap.
You need some pizzazz.
I could not pull it off, mate. I tried so hard, but yeah.
Did you consider a leopard print kind of jumpsuit?
Well, the jumpsuits, obviously.
Obviously,
mate.
That was what you were wearing.
With me now, you know what I mean?
What was the song you were trying to do, if you don't mind me
asking?
Are you going to keep your powder dry?
What do you really, really want?
That's all right.
Mate, so hard to sing. Got massive respect for the Spice Girls because very wordy.
Obviously, you're heading off this year. You're seeing a bit of Russia, Japan as well.
Yeah, Japan, Singapore, New Zealand, Australia. I've got another European tour, another US tour. We're getting about, mate. Yeah. We're getting about.
And you'll get married at some point.
Mate, my carbon footprint's so bad, though. I put it into a website the other day, what I did last year, and we worked out that I'd done 126 flights and put it into this like carbon footprint thing. It would only let me put 30 flights in. Apparently, then a normal
That's
average person
many.
Won't
yeah.
get more than that. And then it was already like, 380% over. So I'm going to have to do some serious offsetting at some
point. You're going to have to plant
some
trees.
I don't know how I'm going to do it, yeah. I'm going to have to plant some trees. I'm going to have to start a forest, essentially.
I worry about all the radiation you're getting from the plane, because obviously, you know, there's a certain amount of radiation you get from the sun.
You get radiation from a plane?
Yeah, yeah. Apparently, really? it's a base level of radiation. So
oh, right.
We might need to hose you down or something.
Maybe, yeah. There must be a cream for that, I'm sure.
Oh, well, Tom, thank you for joining us,
it's
man.
It's been a pleasure, mate.
We've got the dinner. We've got some chips for you, for your hungover self.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, I think there's a bit of food in there, there's a bit of hot dog, I think.
Lovely.
All right, mate. Speak soon.
Thank you. Enjoy that. Well, we've got lots more on the Absolute Radio channel that you'll also like. Subscribe to the Absolute Radio channel, and if you click on the little bell icon, you'll be notified whenever a new one comes along.